Hi folks, the loop antenna I suggested still hides a secret that I haven't understood immediately. Today I would like to explain the working principle of the antenna using a simple and clear representation of the electric fields. I built the antenna for different frequency bands and I also published the corresponding blueprints for it. And the antenna works really good, actually even better than expected. I did some measurements and I found that the antenna always works a few dB better than I expected. Of course, I asked myself why that is. And therefore, I simulated the antenna with NEC and analyzed the complete 3D radiation pattern. And not only with regard to the directional characteristics, but also with a view on the different polarizations that the antenna generates. In this way, I could actually explain why the antenna gives a received signal that is a few dB stronger and less volatile. It gives you a much more stable radio connection than with a simple rod antenna. Okay, in the earlier episodes we have shown through measurements and simulation that the antenna transmits and receives different polarizations. This made it plausible that the antenna has good reception properties in a diffuse radio field, which is practically always the case. By the way, if you want to build the antenna for other frequency bands, then I recommend my Excel tool. This allows you to dimension the antenna for any other frequency band. It might be worth subscribing to the channel and checking out the previous videos on the subject. But after all, I have to admit that it wasn't all that easy to understand. And actually, one last question remained unanswered. Why does the antenna work the way it works? I would like to explain this to you today with a simple and clear presentation. We want to understand the basic principle of this antenna. Actually, I should have done that right from the start. But I couldn't have known at the time that the principle would have a special secret. At least part of it was surprising to me too. An antenna principle can be understood by looking at the electric fields along the wires. First, let's look at the feeding point and the antenna matching. By the way, there are also other videos on the channel where I explained the matching principle and also provided Excel tools for it. Here we have a so-called line transformer for the matching. We know our loop antenna has a high impedance. To transform our transmitter signal from 50 ohms to around 1000 ohms, we connect our 50 ohm cable around here. The voltage or the electric field on our two-wire waveguide now increases according to the transformation ratio the closer we get to the open end. The actual feed point of the antenna is here at the open end and not where the coaxial cable is connected. We have kind of integrated our matching network into the antenna. We will see later that the two-wire line does have an additional effect that I wouldn't have thought of. The impedance matching network's electric fields have no effect at a distance, so I just omit them. We now look at the antenna with its actual feed point here. We can now imagine that we can excite a horizontal mode of oscillation at the ring's resonant frequency. The electric fields then look something like this. And these electric fields would give a radiation diagram that looks similar to that of an electric dipole. The excited ring would then emit a horizontally polarized wave only. In addition, the ring has the additional function of a band filter with a high quality. That's as far as my original expectation went when I had the first idea. However, there was one thing I didn't think about at that time. A second orthogonal oscillation mode is also possible at the same resonant frequency. And this is also stimulated on the ring antenna, namely through the impedance matching network. The matching network brings a slight asymmetry to the arrangement, causing a coupling between the two oscillation modes. This gives us an additional vertical oscillation, which I also represent through the electric fields. As a result, the antenna not only transmits and receives the horizontal polarization, but also the vertical polarization. There are also circular polarized components, as we have seen from the neck simulations. Therein lies the secret of why the antenna has better reception and transmit properties than a rod antenna. Because in a typical radio field, there is always a mixture of all polarizations. This loop antenna can receive all polarizations, while the rod antenna cannot. As a result, it can avoid fading effects in the radio field better than a rod antenna. It can actually receive the energy of radio waves of all polarizations. This brings a few dB more reception power without having a higher directivity. I have to mention here that the term magnetic loop is not entirely correct. This is a loop antenna with a circumference of one wavelength. So please don't get confused, a so-called magnetic loop antenna is usually much smaller. Okay, we explained the working principle of this special loop antenna. That cost me quite a lot of measurements, simulations and considerations. But I think it was worth it, because after all, you don't invent a new antenna every day. And I'm also happy if you were able to learn something from this series of videos. By the way, I didn't find this antenna in any reference book. Maybe the principle is actually new. If you found the principle somewhere else, I would be grateful for your hint. In case you have any questions about it, feel free to ask them in the comments. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.